I'm David Paradiso, and this is Paradiso CrossFit. I was a restaurant manager. I actually worked at a restaurant. Then when we had slow times, I would make my employees do squats, and we'd go in the back and do L-sits and other stuff like that, where I could practice training people for free. Or actually, I guess, get paid for it. Today we have bottom-to-bottom Tabata squats, where you have to hold the 10-second resting position in an active squat at the bottom, and followed by a mile run. So Tabata is 20 seconds of effort, followed by 10 seconds of rest, repeated 8 times. So each round is 30 seconds, and it lasts 4 minutes. One of the main things with the air squat is that it's such a basic movement, people get lazy with it. So one of the things I would focus on is staying tight, focusing on positioning. So make sure her feet get a little bit wider than she's standing now. All right, to make sure her hips have enough room to get that good depth at the bottom. And main thing with the air squat is staying tight in the midline. So you're not gonna lose any length through the midline as you squat. Chest will stay up, back will stay nice and tight. So she's her squat to the bottom. Weight stays in the heels, hips push back, good depth, try to keep the chest up and knees out. Alright? This is gonna be our resting spot for today. So I wanna try to stay nice and tight down there, stand up through the heels, and get full extension at the top. The main thing we're gonna be looking for is keeping a nice tight body position as opposed to squatting real lazy. If you can do a squat and don't think about the midline at all, you kind of cave over at the bottom. Right, you can tell she's just kind of dropping into the knees a little bit. So just focusing on the hips, doing the work, and staying tight in the midline. I mean, that's about it. Running after squatting is no fun, but focusing on my pose running, the main thing that I tell people is to pick their feet up off the ground, right? To not get stuck. When you get tired, your feet stay on the ground forever. So we want to try to focus on keeping the cadence high and pulling your feet up off the ground as quick as possible. That's all I'm thinking about when I'm tired and I run. I just think, keep picking the feet up off the ground and try to feel that hamstring working. If we were to do a couple drills, one of the things I have people do is just start running in place and just try to focus on keeping the same pace, nice easy pull, and then just falling into a lean from there, keeping that same pace as they go, all right? And that way they can feel gravity, they can feel that nice little pull and feel that it's not them pushing themselves along, but rather gravity is nice and easy fall. If Laura were to do it, I would just have her stand in place, arms in position, right? Nice easy pull. And then just lean from there. Oh, my knees buckled running out the door. First 400 was tough to move.
Yeah.
But I still kept thinking pick my feet up, I just don't know if it happened. I'd say holding the bottom of the squat was the crux of that workout. It wrecks your legs. And then the run, you know, is not that long, so. You know, you can fight through it mentally, but it was hard, for sure.